A very good morning class. So we are continuing with the chapter number 2, Nelson Mandela, okay, from the book First Flight. So we are starting. The day was symbolized for me by the playing of our national two anthems and the vision of whites singing Nkosi Sikelel I Africa and blacks singing Die Stem, the old anthem of the republic. So the day you can say it was meant for this Nelson Mandela. He can recognize the day by means there was two types of national anthem sung by the people. First was by the whites, okay, white people were singing Nkosi Sikelel I Africa and blacks were singing the old anthem only, which was sung earlier, okay, that is Die Stem. Although that day neither group knew the lyrics of the anthem they once despised, they would soon know the words by heart. So what he was saying, neither any single person or neither the group, they were not knowing the lyrics, means the words of the anthem they once despised, had a very low opinion of, means they were knowing about the anthem, they would soon know the words by heart. What he was saying that Nelson Mandela was saying that soon they will be learning the anthem, they will come to know the words of the anthem by heart. Okay, on the day of the inauguration I was overwhelmed with the sense of history. So on the day of inauguration, when there was inauguration, the ceremony was held, I was overwhelmed. Overwhelmed have a strong emotional effect. Okay, he became emotional with the sense of history, means while remembering the history, what has happened with him, he became emotional. In the first decade of the 20th century, a few years after the bitter Anglo-Boer War and before my own birth, the white-skinned peoples of South Africa patched up their differences and erected a system of racial domination against the dark-skinned peoples of their own land. So what he was saying that in the first decade, means in the first 10 years of the 20th century, okay, in the 20th century, the first 10 years, a few years after the bitter Anglo-Boer, bitter Anglo-Boer means conflict between Britain and South Africa, okay, there was war between Britain and South Africa, and before my own birth, okay, because he was saying that I was also not born, means Nelson Mandela was also not born even then, the white-skinned people of South Africa, means the white people, those who were living in South Africa, they patched, means they strengthened the differences, okay, they made strong the differences and erected a system, means they built a system of racial domination, means on the basis of race, okay, means this belong to this community, he is a black, he is white, so there was domination against the dark skinned people of their own land, okay, so they were behaving very badly, they were treating as slaves the dark skinned people of their own land, means of South Africa. The structure they created formed the basis of one of the harshest, most inhumane societies the world has ever known. So what type of structure they have created, na? Means whatever system they have created, it came out as the most cruel, okay, as the most cruel rule, or you can say as most cruel behavior in the societies the world has ever known, okay, world has not seen this type of things. Now in the last decade of the 20th century, means in the last time period, means 20th century was getting to be get over, and in the last 10 years, in my own 8th decade, it was his 8th decade as a man, that system had been overturned forever and replaced by one that recognized the rights and freedoms of all peoples. And he was saying now that system, it has been cancelled forever, and now what has taken the place, the rights and freedoms of the people, means people they are having their rights also and freedom also, regardless of the color of their skin, means disregarding, now nobody will dominate them or nobody will discriminate them. That day had come about through the unimaginable sacrifices of thousands of my people, means many people before also they have sacrificed their lives, they have also fought against this discrimination. So he says that after their sacrifices, means thousands of people they have sacrificed, after their sacrifice this day came, people whose suffering and courage can never be counted or repaid. What he is saying, that we can't forget their their sufferings or their, you can say, courage, means they were very courageful, or you can say they were very strong men. So they have fought for this, so they were very strong, and we can't forget whatever they have done. I felt that day, as I have on so many other days, that I was simply the sum of all those African patriots who had gone before me. So what he said, that I was feeling that I am the sum, means I am the result of that. Okay, I am the result that today I am the prime minister. I am result of that, that whatever sacrifices the patriots, means the nationalists, or you can say the soldiers which they have done, okay, whatever sacrifice they have given, so I am the result of that. That long and noble line ended and now began again with me. So now you can say the means freedom of people and right of people, everything I will give to people that has started with me. I was pained that I was not able to thank them and that they were not able to see what their sacrifices has wrought. So he was hurt that he can't thank them. Okay, they were no more na. So he was very hurt that he can't thank them and they can't see that what their sacrifices has achieved. Okay, means they have given so much of, they have given up their lives, they have done so much of sacrifices, and today the result is that we are the president, or we are the rulers of our own country. The policy of apartheid created a deep and lasting wound in my country and my people. So what he's saying, the policy of apartheid means the policy of discrimination, the people were discriminated, it has created a deep and lasting wound, means injury. The people, they are too much hurt or they are too much injured, okay, of his country. All of us will spend many years, if not generations, recovering from that profound hurt. So what he is saying, that it will take too much of time to come out from that injury. But the decades of oppression and brutality had another unintended effect, and that was that it produced the Oliver Tambers, the Walter Sisulus, the Chief Luthiers, the Yusuf Dadas, the Bram Fischers, the Robert Subukwes of our time, men of such extraordinary courage. So he is saying that the decades of oppression means unjust treatment and brutality, means the cruelty, whatever the people, white people have done, okay, it was unintended, means it was that it was not planned, okay, they were just treating the people very badly, and the persons those who have sacrificed their life, their names are written, okay. So these were the men of extraordinary courage. Extraordinary means you can say they were too strong, okay, they were so strong. Wisdom and generosity. Wisdom means the quality of having experience, okay. The people those who have fought or those who have given this their lives, they were having every type of experience and knowledge. And generosity means the quality of being kind, that their like may never be known again, okay. So nobody can be like them. Perhaps it requires such depths of oppression to create such heights of character. So what he is saying, that it takes, means we need depths of oppression to create, okay. We need to become, if we want to become like that na, we also wanted to be to create such type of character. We should have the character like they were having. We want to be so strong. My country is rich in the minerals and gems that lie beneath its soil. So he's saying, my country, it is rich in minerals and gems. Gems are precious stones that he can get under the soil. But I have always known that its greatest wealth is my people. So what he's saying, the greatest wealth is the people of my country. Finer and truer than the purest diamonds, means they are more excellent, and the people, they are more true than any type of pure diamond. It is from these comrades in the struggle that I had earned the meaning of courage. So what he is saying, that I have got this much of courage from whom? From my these friends, those who have sacrificed their lives. Time and again I have seen men and women risk and give their lives for an idea. So what he is saying, the time and again I have seen that many people are sacrificing their life, okay. I have seen men stand up to attacks and torture without breaking, showing the strength and resilience and defies the imagination. So what he is saying, that I have seen many times that people, they have they stood up to attack also, but they were tortured, okay. They were tortured and they were again told, means you are not having this much potential or you are not strong. So they again, what they did, they just ended up without fighting. I learned that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. So what he thought, he told that the courage people are having, na, the power they are having, that is not means they are fearing. Okay, that is just that one day they will win over it. Okay, we have to win over our fear. Okay, we should not do that means we are fearing. We should not think that we should come up over the fear. The brave man is not he who does not feel afraid, but he who conquers that fear. He is saying that everybody is fearing. Okay, the brave is not that means who is not fearing, but the brave is who conquers. Okay, who defeats the fear. No one is born hating another person because of the color of his skin on or his background or his religion. He is saying that no one on this earth is born. Okay, no one is taught that you should discriminate the people of black color or from lower caste or this and that. Okay, no one is taught this thing. People must learn to hate, and if they can learn to hate, they can be taught to love. For love comes more naturally to the human heart than its opposite. Okay, so for he is saying that if anybody is taught to hate, na, so he can learn to love also, because love comes naturally. Okay. For hating we need a reason. Okay, for hating someone we need a reason, but for loving someone we don't need a reason. So that's why he is saying that love, it comes naturally to the human heart. Even in the grimmest times or in prison, means very serious times, okay, when he was in prison, when any comrade and I were pushed to our limits, I would see a glimmer of humanity in one of the guards. What he is saying, that whenever, means his friends, they were pushed to our limits, means pushed to the last point in our ability to bear pain. Okay, means till the time they can bear pain, they were just hitting them. Okay, so I would see a glimmer, means he can see a shine of humanity in one of the guards that were there, perhaps just for a second. Means he is saying that at least that shine is just for a second, but it was there, but it was enough to reassure me and keep me going. Means it encouraged him that you can do it, and he was just doing whatever he want. Man's goodness is a flame that can be hidden but never extinguished. What he is saying, that the thing which is there, means if your heart is good, okay, that can be hidden but it cannot be extinguished, means it cannot be put to an end. So beta, that's all for today. I think so. In next video, we will complete the chapter. So I hope that this much you have understood. Revise it. And if you face any problem, just let me know. Thank you.